Manya, tell us about the smoke. What does the smoke mean? How is it created? And they've made some technological changes over the years, right?
They have, yeah. So they have two stoves now installed in the Sistine Chapel. They use the same chimney. One stove is for burning the ballots after they've been counted. The other is for sending up the smoke signal. And the smoke signal stove is actually electrically operated. It's not as old-fashioned as the ballot burning stove. So hopefully that will guarantee a good strong smoke signal, which was a problem 8 years ago. They sent up the smoke to indicate that there was a pope, and it wasn't quite clear if it was black or gray or white or pink. We didn't know. So they did assure us, though, that it's going to be a little bit clearer this time around. But the way they color that smoke is with chemicals. They actually used to burn wet straw to create the black smoke back in the olden days. But now they told us today, Vatican technicians have come up with a chemical compound to make sure that the color of the smoke is quite clear. And so that's how they're going to actually make it pure white or pure black and clear to the audiences that are watching down below.
So we will see smoke after every vote. It will be black smoke until we see the white smoke, and then that will be the last smoke we see.
The white smoke will be it because we won't care anymore. Right. We will be running and dashing to St. Peter's Square to see who comes out on the balcony in white robes. I mean, white smoke, that means that somebody in there is trading his red robes for white, and that he's accepted or chosen. First of all, he's accepted the role. We won't see the smoke until a couple things have happened, actually. The votes have been counted. It's conclusive. They've chosen a pope. That man has accepted the role because he could turn it down if he wanted. So they do make sure he accepts the job. They have him choose a name. For example, Cardinal Joseph Ratzinger chose Pope Benedict XVI. And then they go, he changes into vestments. There are some rites and liturgies that are conducted with the cardinals. This year, they're adding a step in where he stops en route to the balcony, and he'll stop in the Pauline Chapel and pray before the Blessed Sacrament. He's actually allowed to linger there as long as he wants to pray. But we have been told that it'll probably be about 45 minutes between the white smoke and the introduction on the balcony, depending on how long the new Holy Father chooses to linger and pray.